Hey, if you own a business, you came to the right place. If you don't own a business, you must own a business because owning a business is a lifestyle. However, somebody told me this one 20 years ago, you need to own a business. I did, by the way. Then what happened? I got started getting more customers. Then every time I get customers, I have to sell them. Then many years later, somebody told me that that's not the right way. I become like a salesperson. I keep selling and selling. They say, you are not the best salesperson in your company. I say, why? I'm professionally trained. I can sell to anybody. Tell me right now. I say, no. If you know you are the only best salesperson in the company, you are wrong. That's what they are telling me. Finally, I learned from my mentor. His name is Ted Thomas from Florida. If you don't know him, you need to know him, by the way. I learned from him, your best salesperson is your customer, not you. I said, oh, really? Yeah. Because when you are trying to sell something to someone, guess what? They say, oh, he's going to get my credit card right now. However, when your customer is selling, they are giving a review to you. And now everybody trusts their peers. Like ladies talk to each other, hey, honey, I bought this one from there and they were so good and it was so good. They keep selling the other person without even knowing that part. Why I'm telling you all this, you're probably thinking, I never talked about like this one before. Yes, that's true because this is so special. I have been using it for my success for many years. If you want to look at it, go on YouTube, type my name. I have hundreds of video testimonials from my clients. However, those are my testimonials. Somebody gave it to me. My team edited it out and actually posted it. And we posted the way we want it on our YouTube. However, we are going to find out today. Testimonial is not a review. Review is when you go on a Google, leave a review for somebody when I'm not there. It's unedited the way it is, should be. On Yelp, if you have gone to any restaurant, you go on a Yelp and you read the reviews because people go in your absence and write it over there. Those are all very hard way. If you go on a Google Plus, there are many, many steps before somebody can leave a review. I have to sleep almost like a step number 9. You're almost there. By the time they go to the step number 9 to write a review, you already lost all the energy that you needed from your customers to leave a review. However, there's a smart, better, and easier and faster way. That's the way we are. Today my guests are from a company. It is so amazing name. In fact, I was just asking them how you come up with this so brilliant name. It's so easy. And they are by the family. The middleman you are seeing is Ron Howard. On the left is Trevor. Trevor, say hello.
Hello.
Yeah. On the right side is Troy Howard. It's a Howard's family. And in fact, I'm a new addition to Howard's family, by the way, because they send me an email. Hey, you're welcome. You are a family too. So first I'm going to ask, before you even talk about any business, how come they started all together? Dad and with two sons. I know raising a one son is very hard. You raise two sons and also working together, and we're going to find out all that, the personal side first before we even talk about any business. Ron and two sons, welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ron, Trevor, and Troy, let me start with this. Where were you? What happened? You were all together anyway. Who inspired you to actually come up with how you model this one? We need to work together because working with a family, let me tell you before you answer anything, is very hard. I worked with my wife worked for me since 97 to 2008. My brother still worked with me over 15 years. So I know the feeling. My brother-in-law, my wife's brother, is still working with me for many years. And my brother-in-law, who is my sister's husband, worked for me for a short time, then kind of, you know, separate. We still have the family together, you know. So it's very hard. It's very challenging. I want to know that part first before we even get on any business because we want to know how you manage it. I think I manage pretty well, but I still have the weaknesses because we want to improve it.
Well, okay. As a dad, I started the company and just realized that I couldn't do it all. I didn't have all the skills. And I brought on my youngest son to begin with, Trevor, who was an artist. I mean, he is outgoing. He's just absolutely incredible with his skills and talents. He sees things a little differently than what I do. And then I brought on my older son, who is a genius in putting things together and thinking outside the box. And so we each have our own talents that we bring to this business that makes us unique. And then I was smart enough to raise them to love the family, to be part of the family. And I think that's what made this thing really go, is that I love working with them. That's why I come to work, is that so I get a chance to work with my two sons.
That's amazing. The next question is, do they love working with the dad? Okay, Trevor, you go first.
Yeah, actually, it's great. You know, for a lot of years when I was growing up, my dad was actually a traveling salesman. He was out there selling millions of dollars for everybody else. And so I felt like I really didn't see him much in my younger youth. So working together for the last 16 years has been phenomenal. And I'll actually add, he said he raised us to love the family. He also raised us by shoving wonderful things like Mark Victor Hansen and Zig Ziglar down our throats. I used to go to sleep listening to these guys, and that's what Dad would do to us. So he's also raised us in that way as well.
So, Ron, that paid off eventually, is that right?
It did pay off. It really did.
That's amazing. Try, tell us. It's your turn now.
It's actually been amazing working with him. We love it. It's like Ron said, it's one of the reasons why he comes to work, and it's one of the reasons why I come to work. I'm 8 years older than Trevor, and I was, you know, when I left the house, he was like 10, 11 years old, so I almost felt like I didn't even know him. And it wasn't until we started working together that I found my brother and really my best friend in the world besides my dad, you know, and I found that through the business.
Okay, do I have permission to ask you some tricky questions?
Sure, go right ahead.
Okay, wonderful. So I know working in a family and like a work and family things sometimes get mixed, like it's for the wrong reason. It could be anything. You know, we all, at everything whatever do in a life has its own set of challenges. And sometimes we live in with interesting situations. How do you deal with them, Dad?
I found that we sit down and we discuss it out. I would say that 99% of the time that we're all on the same page. There's going to be a tiff once in a while when somebody's going, well, I don't understand. But when we sit down together, then we sit down and we decide what's the best thing for everybody. And then everybody goes with that.
Trevor, you tell me, when something happened here, Dad says, okay, I said, I'm your dad. And then you go home, they tell my wife, honey, this is what happened. Then how you kind of know this whole environment is?
First, actually, Dad is really good at not pulling that string, right? So he doesn't say, hey, I'm Dad and this is what we're doing. In fact, the funny thing is we have similar personalities often, and we're very energetic people. So often he and I are saying the same thing and we're not realizing it. And Troy steps in and says, hey, guys, whoa. Let's pull this apart. And do you realize you're both saying the exact same thing? Troy's kind of that that glue that holds us together. He's a different personality than we are. I definitely have learned in the last 16 years, I don't go home and complain to my wife. That's for sure. I don't want to bring any kind of contention in, because something that might happen here in this moment, it's only a moment. At work, and we're going to get right through it. We're going to get right past it. And if I take that home, she might hold on to that longer than we are. So I've learned that it's all roses and wonderful things when I talk to my wife.
So here's the one thing you learned, Troy, you can second me on this one. You learn how to contain the fire at this place, not leave this boundary. Is that right?
Yeah, that's absolutely right. Everything in the business stays in the business. And you and I talked about how even when we're at work, we don't call Dad, Dad. We call him Ron, because at work, it's Trevor, Ron, and Troy. But as soon as we walk out the business door, it's Dad.
Oh, okay. It's amazing. First of all, congratulations, Dad. This is a very, very like amazing thing. This is the best thing you have achieved in your life. Forget the business part. Business, we do anything. Oh. We make money. Doesn't matter. Because holding family together, talking, looking at your sons at this age, together every day, that's the best day in your life every day.
Every day. And that is the absolute truth. I couldn't be prouder of these two guys. They're amazing. Sometimes I think, oh my gosh, how am I so lucky to be working with them?
So what's the lesson for other people like me who are working from with their family? Family may not be with sons and daughters and, you know, like an immediate family member, that's the definition. Give us some, like one or two tips how they can hold them together and actually recover it from that situation, because that contention is always everywhere. You know?
I think what Trevor said is, I don't do the trump card, a dad trump card. This is a partnership and we're in this together. And so each one of us has our unique abilities. And so the other day we were sitting down and I says, okay, I'm having a problem with this. I need a better perspective. I need you to look at this. And sure enough, when they came in, they opened up a whole new avenue. We'd be able to think outside the box, make it different. And that's what we really try to go after is we are a team when we're here at work. It isn't dad and sons. It's a team. And so nobody's got any more power over it. And I don't pull the trump card as a dad.
Yeah, and I would add to that it's important to understand we're all working for the same thing. We're all working towards that same goal. And each one of us has our voice and we have our special skill sets and we see things differently. And if you can learn to appreciate that and understand it and respect it, then it just works. It works flawlessly.
Troy, anything you want to give a tip for someone?
The only tip I would give is the one that Trevor mentioned a little bit earlier, which is leave work at work and leave family outside of that, meaning that you don't take anything home to your spouse. Trevor's absolutely right, because we could have a conflict in the office. We're over it. I go home, I tell it to my wife, and she may stew on it for 4 days, you know, because she never had the resolution. So don't take the business outside of the business, and then forgive. Be quick to forgive. We're all human. We all have opinions, and we all have needs. So if there is something, if there's a conflict, be quick to forgive and just focus on what's best for the business.
Wonderful. Let me add this one, because I have a little experience too here. We are talking, you know, you're watching this. You need to know all this one. You know why? All the reasons Ron, Trevor, and Troy was giving, they are all good on its own. However, if I have to sum up in one word, I'm going to sum up this one. Dad, watch this. That all goes to with this one word.
That's true.
Is that true?
Trust each other.
You trust each other. You know what? Once you trust each other, they are your business partner, they are your team, that now you have a successful team. Winning team is you need to have, and the winning team cannot be without any trust. You have to trust with them with your life. That's what really matters. Then now you got the winning team, and you know your best customers are also part of your winning team, by the way.
Well, if I had to go into battle, these would be the two guys I'd want to take with me.
That's it. That's what, again, back to the same word. You know, exactly. It's not only your son.
It's trust.
It's a trust.
Absolutely. Completely.
Yeah. We are 5 brothers and 2 sisters. I don't trust all of them. You know what? You have to pick one or two, because not all are same. I'm telling you right now. Okay. So that's the key. Okay. So now these guys, wise, like a dad and 2 sons, they created a company, and the credit goes to, I'm going to pick one, and credit goes to the name of that company is, credit goes to Troy. Troy, tell us what the name of the company is and why you even choose that name. What inspired you to come up with the name?
The name actually came from my wife and I were driving to California, taking the kids on a trip, and we spent about 6 hours in the car, and we had this idea for this system, the app, and we were trying to come up with a name. So we were just rolling names for about 6 hours trying to figure it out. And I'm driving, she's on her phone checking to see what domain names are available. Finally came down to it, and we said, well, what's this all about? And we said, it's all about your customers loving your service and then telling you about it. I mean, that's what you want. You want your customers to tell everybody else about the service. And that's when SoTellUs came out. Basically, love our service, SoTellUs.
The moment I saw this, SoTellUs, it is so genius. I need to find out the story about that one. It is like it's like a stick to my mind. I couldn't even stop myself. I said, we need to get these guys on this video interview so we can learn all that from one, and we can implement in our business. How we really actually, it's a customer focus. It's not your pocket focus, you know. It's a customer focus. So you have a business now. That was my promise. You need to know what? You need to be a best salesperson, and your best salespeople are your customers. And your best salespeople, customers only becomes when they are happy with your service. The moment they are happy with your service, you need to tell them, come on, let me know right now. Don't go on Google and go follow the 9-step formula. By the time somebody else calls, the process is already gone. Plus, it's an emotional thing. It's a state of mind when the customer is happy or not happy. It's their state of mind. The moment, catch them while they are in your time zone. You know, in your zone, when they're talking, well, I love your service. I tell my friends, can you say the same thing on the damn this video right now? I'm going to send you the text. That's what you want to do. And you are a chiropractor or any business, does not matter. Even on internet, even if I work from home, we all have a customer. If you have no customer, your shop is already, by now is already closed. You don't need to be watching this. You can go home right now. You know, you can stop this video, because this is only for people who have a business already. Or you're planning to start a business, don't go in your business. This is a part of your launching startup, by the way, because you need to have how you can collect reviews from your customers. Even the first one, in fact, the first one you need badly when you don't have a business. Because your first view is going to help you to get more customers, by the way, because your customer is the best salesperson on the planet, because everybody trusts your customer, not you, because the moment you tell the same word, oh, this guy is going to sell me something, but the customer is telling, they're sharing their experience. So SoTellUs is the app. We are going to have your amazing thing, something, and how you can actually use it. I'm going to invite these three, or one or two, I don't know who is going to come. We will see. Why don't you tell us by writing a comment underneath who you want to learn it from. You want to learn from Dad, Ron Howard, or Trevor, or Troy. I have no idea. I like to learn all from three, but I have no idea what you are looking at it. Why don't you write a comment underneath? I'm going to bring them back. I have no idea what's going to ask. I'm going to ask for a permission first. Is it okay if I invite you for 30 minutes, another webinar where you show us the whole application and show us how people are using it, and what kind of results they are getting it, and how folks can get involved from my team, my donors, my sponsors, my Neil Al-Sharif Foundation sponsors, and many, many of students who can help you to actually become an affiliate to this application. This is so good. Once you start using it, you will never stop. You will, you know what, the day you want to cancel the service, that will be the day you want to close your business. Whenever. That's it. You cannot stop using this service. Why? Because you need to get more customers. The reviews are never enough. You need more. If you don't know the value, go on Amazon.com. The best sellers who have thousands of reviews, they still need more. Whenever you tell them, I will give you a good review, they say, I give you 10% off coupon. They don't even need it. But they know the value of a review. They are making millions of dollars a year, even a month sometimes. I know them personally too, some of them. If you want to learn how to get the right review from the customer and the zone, when they are in the zone, what to say to them, how to ask for a review from them, I'm going to bring them back. I'm going to ask for permission in front of you so you can watch what they say. I have no idea. They can't say no. I'm going to ask them a question where they can only say yes, because thousands of people will be want to get on that one. Ron, what's the answer?
Answer is yes.
Why you said yes?
One of the greatest things about this product is once your customer tells you how good you are and you capture it on video, now they can actually have it. They become a better customer because they have their elevator speech. They can return around and sell that to somebody else, tell somebody else, because they know what they're going to say. They become a better customer of yours.
You know, in the social media world, the moment SoTellUs application gave me the video back, I'm going to tag that person. Even though he doesn't like to tell his friends where he got it from, I'm going to tag that person. All of the 5,000 friends will know it automatically. The top five stalkers who are their close friends, they're always watching, being a nosy, you know. They're watching the person, what they're doing, especially ladies. I'm sorry, I have one at home. I know that how that works. So they will be becoming your friends, like buying it from your business. This is like a viral, you can't even stop. They can't lie because they just had it on the video already. They don't know what happened with them. They can say, no, I was just faking it up. No, they are losing the credibility, not you. How they can say I faked it up on a video? Especially coming from a third party verified place, it's a typical, like a third party review. It's a permission based, again, everything we are going to share with you, and that private webinar only for the people who will be interested in. I really appreciate that. Trevor, Ron, and Troy, anything you want to say as a final word? Because once I have 1,000 people interested, then I'm going to set a time with you. I want to see, let's see, 1,000 people are want to in. By the way, if you don't have a business, you want to promote something like this, and you want to make an affiliate commission, I love you even better, by the way. You know why? Because you will do everything to make money for the life of the sale, by the way. Not one time, not two times, not even 1 year, not 2 years. As long as they are, how long you have been in business, by the way? I didn't ask you that question.
16 years.
So imagine you were working with them as an affiliate 16 years ago and you are still making money. How good is that? That's the level of, it's a family thing. So you want to, even though you want to learn as become an affiliate, I want you to register for that training because it's not a selling part. We will ask you to kind of get on board. However, I want you to learn it, experience it first, then actually promote it. If you don't like it from your heart, don't promote it. It's not good. It's not good for you. Don't do it. You have to know, like, and trust the product. Like I just mentioned, you the one word, trust. If you, when I'm bringing something, I trust the product. Otherwise, I won't bring it. You know me already. That's why I have to be very careful who I'm bringing it. And plus, this product is going to help you or your customers to borrow that trust and transfer back to you so you get more sales. This is like a customer and best reviews is everything that makes you happy. That's why you can have a good night's sleep because you didn't screw up. Your customers are happy. That's why you listen to the feedback. Ron, what would you say as a final word?
What's so cool about this is that everybody, any business, has their ups and downs. And if you've got 20, 30, 40, 100 people saying how great you are, go watch those reviews and all of a sudden you're back on top of the cloud again. That's another thing it does for you. It tells you how good you are.
Very well said. Troy?
My final word would be that we're just really excited to do a webinar. You know, we love working with business owners. We've worked with thousands over the last 16 years. And it's not about our business, just our business. It's about helping other businesses. That's why we built the product, is to help other businesses grow and to help people who are promoting the product to grow. The reason we do affiliates for the last 16 years is because we love to help people change their lives.
And you pay a lifetime.
That's
lifetime.
Exactly why we do it, because I can't change your life if I don't pay for the life.
Wonderful, wonderful. Trevor?
I would just second kind of what Troy said. You know, we do this. We're a family-owned business. We've worked together for so long. We truly care about our clients. We truly care about people and businesses. And that's kind of a premise of why this whole system was created, is we care about these people and we want to help people. We want to make a difference in the world. And we can start with one business at a time. So I'm excited.
Why do you care so much about your business? That's the feeling like you don't care about yourself. You care about your customer. That's my feeling coming along. Why is that? Is that an overrated thing or you really want to care about customers? That's how you bring, I know.
Yeah, and the way I would answer that is Trevor actually said this a while ago and it resonated with me. We are a customer service company that just happens to do this product or that product. We're not a software company or a system company that has customer service. Our customers are first. That's our business. We just happen to give a product to our customers. And that really resonates with who we are. That's why we care, because they're everything to us.
Okay. I want to go. My final word is, if you have a customer who trusts you, if they don't trust you, you need to work it out right away, because you will not be in a business long time. I'm telling you right now. If you have a customer who trusts you, they need to say it on a video. Don't tell me I have a happy customer. Show me. You have nothing to show. What do you mean happy customers? Don't talk about it. I have happy customers. Everybody who screw everybody else, they always talk. They look nice. They talk with themselves. Let your customers talk about you. That's what we want to care. And I will be bringing you on the new webinar. There's a link somewhere on the video. Find it up, down, left, right, somewhere. I know you are going to find out the link automatically wherever that is once you want to be on that webinar. Because guess what will happen? That can change your business life 3x, 2x, 1x. I have no idea. It's all up to you how happy customers you have and you're delivering it. However, without this SoTellUs, there's no way you can do it. This is the smartest, easier, and better way I found it, and I'm sharing with you. Thank you so much, Ron, Trevor, and Troy, for sharing your wisdom with us today on the behalf of Pakistani Social Entrepreneurship Academy and its entire community. We really appreciate you. This is Mohammed Siddique signing off from Atlanta, Georgia, wishing you good luck, good sales, and I do hope to path across again with another amazing guest. Until then, bye-bye.
Bye.